Hey folks, this is Bardic Dragoon. Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect.
Good timing, Commander. We got a transmission coming in from the Citadel. Top priority clearance.
I'll take it in the comm room.
Anyway, when we last left off, we had... well... found that people were doing things they probably shouldn't be with science on a frozen hunk of ice, and... decided not to commit genocide, so... good times in general. Not a lot of acid-spitting bugs, but apparently we've got a message for us.
Commander Shepard, we've received information that may be critical to your mission against Saren.
I'll take all the help I can get.
We've received an urgent message from one of our infiltration regiments in the Traverse.
I'm listening.
We currently have several infiltration units scattered throughout the border regions of Citadel space. This particular unit was gathering intel on Saren.
What did they find?
Unfortunately, the message we received was little more than static. The infiltration team must be in a situation where they can't set up proper interstellar communications. But the message was sent on a channel reserved for mission-critical communications. Whatever they were trying to tell us, we know it was important. Considering your interest in Saren, we thought you might want to investigate this. Find out what happened to our team. The signal originated from the planet Virmire.
I'll look into it.
The Council prefers not to become involved in the specifics of Spectre activities. We only want you to be aware of all your options, including Virmire. Good luck, Commander Shepard. We will keep you advised if we learn anything else.
All right. One quick check here. Where did Lee... oh, yeah. That's right. We are so close to maxed out. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. We're gonna do this. Neat trick, you don't even have a biotic field going at all. Stuff, Holmes. Anyway, I was originally planning to do some side quests here, but you know what? I think we're gonna forego side quests between main missions. I suppose, technically, considering we did X-57 after, immediately after rescuing Liara, I guess that's not exactly like we're out the realm of things that, you know, we've done doing it this way, but I digress. We're going to go to Virmire. The only thing out here in Virmire, Hawk. And we're going to take on another main story mission. We'll leave the side quest for later. We've got stuff to do. Namely, track down mysterious messages that may or may not be about Saren. So, that should be exciting. I hope. I kind of hope all these videos are exciting, or at least interesting. But who knows. Alright, so of course, that's where we need to go, Virmire. But... you have to do our standard, check every planet nearby. If there's anything, you know, useful we can get from these rocks. Or, I suppose some of them are balls of gas. That one's a ball of gas. Like, super... well, not really a ball of gas, it's a ball of superheated plasma. Well, can you really have not superheated plasma? Like, I'll admit, I'm not a physicist, but... considering what plasma is and how it's created, I don't think you can have not superheated plasma. I mean, feel free to correct me if I'm wrong on that. Hey, there we go. Hello, phone. Let me pull up my web browser and do a quick... because I completely forgot I was doing that here. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Resources. No, wait, no, it's not there. Boy, you'd think I wasn't prepared to record right now. I really am not. Okay. Where is my 2d6? 2d6. 4 and 4. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. I seem to get this team a lot. I'm not complaining, but I'm just saying, I seem to get this team a lot.
Commander, I'm reading a signal. Must be our Solarian infiltration team.
Check out those defense towers.
Drop the Mako. We'll go in hot and take them out.
I'll get you in underneath their radar, Commander.
Of course we're doing a drop in the Mako.
Got a clean drop, Commander.
Stay out of range and continue evasive maneuvers until I bring those AA towers down.
I know the drill. Meet you at the camp once those towers are offline. Joke around.
This one's kind of weird in the fact that it drops you in the Mako, but you're not in the Mako. I'm guessing because they needed that cutscene, but I don't know. So I'm pretty sure it's been a while since, yeah. Kaiden's caught up. He was with us on, frozen ice ball, but Garrus is a little behind. What was I doing with him? Encryption and electronics are the important ones, first of all. And beyond that, I think I want to get you to medium armor. Yeah, because... Adrenaline burst isn't going to be too useful for you. First, get you to assassination. There we go. Now you can use medium armor. And I think I sold all my armor, so you won't get to use any yet. But you can do that when we, have the option, I think. Yeah, we don't have any armor. I'm sure we'll pick up some medium carrying armor. We seem to find it, under every rock, practically, so... Yeah, it was kind of a waste of the weapon cooldown, but I don't care. I wanted to blow up a giant crab. And... oh, there it is. I also want to run over a giant crab! I might be a horrible person. Anyway!
Enemy contact!
Ow! So yeah, this is pretty much our standard Mako section of a mission. Well, you're not the red dot, you're a crab. So, we'll proceed in it, kind of like we have all the other ones. We've had two of these by now. I figure you guys get how the pattern works by now. And if not, well... who am I to judge? You guys find me entertaining. Obviously, there's something wrong with you. Oh, that didn't go well. I presume you guys find me entertaining. Maybe you find me informative. I think I'd be far cooler with being informative than being entertaining, but... I'm not too upset either way.
Moving out.
No, get back in the tank, get back in the tank, get back in the tank, get back in the tank. Stop being idiots. I pressed the wrong button, that was my bad, but, stop shooting at the boat. Actually, these things really aren't, handle in tank only, don't go on foot kind of enemies. But I feel like blowing things up with the tank. Anyway, given that, we're not doing anything too different from, what we were doing about two or three videos ago, and did another time before that, you know what? It occurs to me I really didn't spend a lot of time talking about the classes, I kind of gave a brief overview of, my opinion on the classes when we first started and we were at the character creation. My opinion on what would be more interesting to watch and what I enjoyed playing. But I didn't get too much into the classes. I didn't really even touch too much on Vanguard, at least not in the way that I'm saying things. Obviously, playstyle, I'm playing a Vanguard. And I'm not doing half bad at it, if I do say so myself. But... well, let's go through the shield. Yes, that's great. Okay. I don't know what those shields are hiding. So let's do that. Let's talk about, of course, starting with the wonders of the Vanguard. Because, one of the things that I do like in this, and I think I kind of mentioned it briefly in the whole why I kind of don't like this game, at least didn't like this game. I'm a lot more on board with this game being good than I once was, so, take that for what it is. But I've said it before, but the combat is nowhere near as janky and Well, okay, it might still be broken. I'm just not... I'm intentionally not taking advantage of broken strategies here. It's still a little janky, though. But the combat in this is actually not too bad, and I mean, I guess, I'm pretty sure I said before, I kind of, like, BioWare's kind of design, one of the things I think BioWare's biggest strengths are its combat mechanics, though unfortunately not its combat design. It really doesn't know how to design a good fight 90% of the time. There are a few exceptions. One of the deals, actually, a lot of the well-designed fights tend to be in the DLC for their games. I don't know what to make of that or how to feel about that, but yeah, DLC for Mass Effect 2 had one of the better boss fights. From what I've heard, one of the DLCs for Mass Effect 3 has a really good set of, like, optional missions that are pure combat-focused. Dragon Age 2, the whole... Oh, what was that one? Actually, both Dragon Age 2 DLCs had a lot of better combat design than the main game did for the most part, but... Like, there's one particular I'm trying to remember here. The one where you have to, like, infiltrate the... You know, highfalutin, you know, dinner party. What the heck are you shooting at, Kaiden? Oh! That's what you're shooting at, okay. But, yeah, I cannot remember. I think it's like Mark of the Assassin or something like that, I don't know. But that had a really good boss fight and some decent, regular encounters. The other big DLC that it had... It had a lot of good encounters, but honestly, the boss fight... What are you two shooting at? Anyway. But yeah, I'm getting off track here, though. Like I said, I feel like their combat mechanics are one of their high points, but their combat design isn't. The other thing I think that BioWare does really well... is character class design. Like, they have got that stuff down pat. Yeah. You might get... Yeah. And I think we had some pistols for you to check out really quickly. Nope. How about... Okay. Oh. Had some level up points to spend, too. Yeah, might as well go for it. And what, it's an extra 10% shield per second. I didn't mean to actually hit okay, but fine. Or, well, same duration. And same thing. Actually, that's another mechanic I want to talk about, but we'll leave that for the moment. And let's just start putting into Spectre training, because I really don't know what else to do. Not that I really feel like I'll have a lot of use for stasis, but might as well have all my options available. And, yeah, we'll go ahead and go for that. Okay. And, really, I mean, like I said, a lot of things about Mass Effect 1's combat doesn't quite work out too well. Okay, let's see. Oh, Geth Ghosts. So basically the Geth Sniper, or not the Snipers, the other folly things. I can't remember the names. But just not as good. Oh, whoa, what the heck am I doing? That is not the button I wanted. I wanted... I wanted my grenades. Yeah, Stalkers, that's it. They're basically... Ghosts are basically upgraded Stalkers. Anyway. And like I said, the Mass Effect series... It doesn't become quite as obvious until the second and third games, where they really get their game, really find their game in getting the combat and the class design and all that right, but
ready to move.
That wasn't what they wanted to talk to you. I think we were supposed to do something with that console. I hope the game hasn't bugged out here. But yeah, but you can kind of see a lot of the ideas, you know, in place in this one, just not quite fully formed. The Vanguard is probably one of the few ones where that, like, is completely a false statement. Like, the idea of the Vanguard is kind of here in the fact that they have the shotgun, which, unless you really go for a particular style of leveling up your skills and abilities, in which case you can snipe with a shotgun, because God only knows that's not an incredibly idiotic idea that should not work, but does for whatever reason. But yeah. So they're kind of, you know, meant to be the high risk, high reward in the fact that their survivability mechanically isn't that great. Like, the highest survivability in the game is really the soldier, purely because of the fact that armor does a lot more. Like, armor and health are your best things, because there are enough ways for shields to go through, or to, like, get through shields, both from you as a player getting through enemy shields and enemies getting through your shields. Look! Little mini armatures! But yeah. So, having shield really doesn't do a lot of good, hence why, even though you can get some insane numbers on your shields if you're playing, I'd probably say, Infiltrator's probably the best, like, as far as just having stupidly high volumes of shields, but Sentinels aren't too bad at it either, and Vanguards definitely have their tricks up their sleeve. So even then, Vanguards aren't that great on the shields front, just because their main thing is barrier, which is temporary shield. It's not permanent shield. So, like, you can boost your shields on top of the shields from medium armor, but shields aren't that good, and barrier is only a temporary boost compared to the shield bonuses that Sentinels and Infiltrators get. Actually, I think, no, Infiltrators, Sentinels get more because you can... They get all the same bonuses that Infiltrators do, plus they also get Barrier, so, you know, best of both worlds are the worst form of defense, or something. Seems like the better way to say that. But yeah, Vanguards are actually a very squishy class. They're, like, they don't have a lot in the way of HP boosting options besides the universally available Spectre training. So that's not really something to be worth bringing up as, like, a strength to Vanguards, because everybody has that. And actually, yeah, health, it does boost health. But yeah, none of their other stuff, unless I think one of their specialties might have some health boosting, but I don't remember, so don't quote me on that. But yeah, like, you get damage reduction from medium armor and from boosting your tactical armor skill. You know, you get boost to health, but that's, like, a not really powerful thing. So they are largely very squishy classes. Good googly moogly, we got a lot of stuff here. Nah, nothing useful there. Nothing useful there. I was looking in there and I noticed they had a lot of stuff. That's still metal face. So then again. Let's go full Vanguard for a while. Why not? Yeah, okay, that works. Okay, anyway. But, like I was saying, it's a really squishy class for what's supposed to be a Russian and melee-focused class. You know, they have... I mean, admittedly, the boost to melee that they have are the same ones you get for a soldier. But considering that their options in combat are pistols, which admittedly are a really good mid-range weapon and just good weapon overall, and shotguns, which, you know, unless you cheese the game, really only work at close range. They're supposed to run in, but they're kind of a squishy class, but their biotic skills, well, let's jump back into here for a moment. You'll notice they have throw, knocks enemies to the ground. You can eventually learn lift, which allows you to disable enemies, and then warp, which, you know, reduces the damage detection, so allowing you to get through enemy armor. It's really the only skill that allows you to bypass enemy damage resistance, as opposed to just, you know, stripping shields or, you know, doing higher damage. So there's that. It's got that going for it. But yeah, they have, like, they're really a class that's about getting in close and creating the opportunity to get in close. Shotguns have good knockback, so you can usually, you know, get in close, knock the enemy down, and kind of keep them stunlocked to go for the melee kill, or just, you know, keep them stunlocked with the shotgun. You've got push, which gives you...
There's our target, Commander.
Options. Hi! Bye. And... Oh, what the heck? That's why you don't drive in the first-person view. It's... You're looking to run into a rock. But yeah. Like I said, the second and third game gets it a lot better thanks to the introduction of class-unique skills, which really boosts all the classes. But, you know, whereas some of the other ones can be argued as you, through combining certain skills, you could achieve the same outcome in this game, the Vanguards really don't have anything like that. Okay, that probably just was like kicking a hornet's nest, but we'll act like it wasn't a bad idea. Anyway, and so like I said, I also just because of that, I feel like Vanguards are the more visually interesting. Let me crouch, please. All right. Mr. Alenko, you get on and get your focus on him. That took way more shots than it should have. There we go. Alright. But, and then the other classes, like I said, there are some interesting things to them. I feel like, at least, well, my next favorite one, personally, is... Oh. You guys are too good at your jobs, man. I mean, I'm not complaining. It makes the enemies fall down and go boom, but whatever. Anyway... My next favorite class, though, after this is... I can't... Well, I might be able to. Is Scimitar a good one? Actually, wait, a blade of coating. That's what Garrus is using, isn't it? There we go. Alright. But it's the Infiltrator. Which is... Well, basically, it's your sniper class. Their primary weapon are sniper rifles, and their skill sets are more tech-based. That's actually... Garrus, you can kind of consider as a infiltrator. And his skills are a little bit different, but, you know, you get, like, electronics, stripping through enemy shields, decryption, disable enemy guns. As an infiltrator, you actually get, instead of assault training, which I don't know why they give that to him. I mean, adrenaline burst, I guess, is a good option. But yeah, you actually get Oh, why can I not remember what the skill is now? The one that basically makes you immune to damage, or at least gives you a really large boost to damage reduction, which, you know, you combine that with their, by having electronics and access to medium armor. God, the cursor moves a little too fast sometimes. Whatever. I feel like none of those are probably worth it. Eight controls, disable power, and it'll end up doing anything. Alright, first things first. There we go. Okay.
I'm reading that the grid is down, Commander. I want to approach the Solarian base now. Out.
Good job for you, Joker. Okay, but yeah. And so, that kind of gives them, basically, like I said, there's a sniper class, and their skill set is really focused on stripping enemy shields, the basically bypassing enemy shields, and then lining up the perfect headshot by basically disabling enemy weapons, reducing your damage intake by a pretty drastic amount. You can pretty much sit there and carefully aim headshots and go for the kill. There's another wall here. Well, I guess I'll kill these things. After that, I guess in this game, I guess the Adept would probably be my next favorite class after Infiltrator. Mostly because in this game, I think I mentioned it on the character creation screen, but I really don't feel like engineers were well thought out and implemented in this game as they were in the later ones. Now, a lot of that has to do with the changes they made to the combat in the sequels, but it still stands that, yeah, in this one, engineers, well, tech skills are by and large about locking the enemy down. Actually, pretty much anything that isn't a weapon damage buff is about locking down the enemy and reducing their options in combat. And it pretty much, I mean, engineers, by having all of the tech-based skills, are really good at that. But it's also borders on a bit of overpowered when you really get an engineer in there going full ham on just locking down. Like, you can pretty much completely shut down an enemy's offensive options with a good engineer build. Now, you do want to, you know, you don't want to, like, go too hard on that, just because.
That's the last one. We should be able to reach the Solarian camp.
Oh, hey, level up. Good for us. But yeah, you can pretty much, like, you don't want to, like, just do everything and completely lock the enemy down at the start of the fight, because most of the buffs don't last long enough for you to finish the fight in that time. But, you know, by timing and, like, planning out your use of the tech skills, you can kind of keep the enemy largely locked down and locked out of, you know, a lot of offensive options, and it doesn't take a lot of effort. And, like, that's not a bad strategy. It's actually quite a good one. It just doesn't feel as good in something like a third person, like a game like this, compared to, you know, I think I made it before, that made the, or said it before, but it feels like the combat mechanics are far more inclined towards something like Baldur's Gate or Dragon Age more than the third person shooter with RPG on the plane here.
Down at the base, but it looks like we're grounded.
By the way, you can drive off of that. You can drive off of that and get yourself killed. We're not going to do that. But yeah. Biotics are kind of the same way. The Adepts, because of the fact that their ability is more about controlling space than directly locking down opponents, it's a little bit more interesting. But since, you know, you have a lot of abilities that basically disable the opponents, it still feels like a very similar thing. It's just that, you know, you have a lot more variety. Alright. Well, here's a Salarian camp. Let's run through it with a tank! Oh, wait, we're here to help. Sorry.
So what are we supposed to do now?
Stay put until we can come up with a plan.
Are you in charge here? What's the situation?
I'm Captain Kirahi, 3rd Infiltration Regiment STG. You and your crew have just landed in the middle of a hot zone. Every AA gun within 10 miles has been alerted to your presence.
Oh, that's just great. What now?
We stay put until the Council sends the reinforcements we requested.
We are the reinforcements.
What? You're all they sent? I told the Council to send a fleet.
We couldn't understand your transmission. They sent me to investigate.
That is a repetition of our task. I lost half my men investigating this place.
So what have you found?
Saren's base of operations. He set up a research facility here, but it's crawling with Geth and very well fortified.
What's Saren researching?
He's using the facility to breed an army of Krogan.
How is that possible?
Apparently, Saren has discovered a cure for the Genophage.
The Geth are bad enough, but a Krogan army... he'd be almost unstoppable.
Exactly my thoughts. We must ensure that this facility and its secrets are destroyed.
Destroyed? I don't think so. Our people are dying. This cure can save them.
If that cure leaves this planet, the Krogan will become unstoppable. We can't make the same mistake again.
We are not a mistake.
Is he going to be a problem? We already have enough angry Krogan to deal with.
Don't worry about it, Captain.
I do worry. That's why I'm still alive. Why don't you go talk to the Krogan? My men and I need some time to come up with a new plan of attack. In the meantime, if you need any supplies, you can talk to Commander Rentola. He's in one of the tents nearby.
Looks like things are a bit of a mess.
Yeah. I wouldn't be so worried if it wasn't for Rex. He looks like he's gonna blow a gasket.
You think I should go talk to him?
It wouldn't hurt. Well, it might, actually. Just do it carefully.
Rex doesn't worry me. He'll fall in line.
If you say so. But I'm gonna keep my eye on him, if it's all the same to you.
Alright, well, this is a situation we're in.
I'm concerned about Rex. Can we still trust him? With all these defenses, Saren must be hiding something big. Last thing we need is an Krogan on our team.
I'm guessing those are AA guns going off in the background that are really loud.
Having battle frightens me, but I know Saren must be stopped. The Krogan seems very upset. The Salarians are willing to die to stop Saren, and so am I.
Advanced Unity seems like a good choice here. And, what the heck, let's work our way towards getting lift. That seems like a good plan. Oh. Ooh. Super Weeaboo weapon choices go. Katana's always the best thing ever, right? I feel like I'm going to probably want to... I can't remember what the upgraded version of Hammerhead rounds are, though. Oh well, whatever. And... do we even have... nope. Nope, don't have anything there. Ty, do you have anything useful?
Greetings, human. I am Commander Rentola. I can provide you with supplies for the upcoming mission. For anything else, I suggest you speak with Captain Kirahi.
Let me see what you have.
What little there is.
There we go. Yes, please. Alright. Don't really care about the rest of it. Anyway, back to what I was talking about with the whole class design in the game, though. Like I said, Adepts and Engineers are kind of different flavors of the same thing. I find Adepts to be a little bit more entertaining just because I like the idea of the biotic abilities, and even though they don't really get a lot of mileage out of doing unique things with them until later in the series, I still kind of like the idea, and it feels like there are some really cool things that can be done with it. And of course, because I don't have any of my tech people, I can't unlock any of this stuff.
I am worried that Rex's allegiance to you may be waning.
Yeah, your people are all saying the same thing. Fine, I'll talk to the Krogan.
This isn't right, Shepard. If there's a cure for the genophage, we can't destroy it.
I understand you're upset, but we both know Saren's the enemy here. He's the one you should be angry with.
Really? Saren created a cure for my people. You want to destroy it. Help me out here, Shepard. The lines between friend and foe are getting a little blurry from where I stand.
I shouldn't have to explain that to you, Rex.
Indulge me. If you can't give me a better reason than this to destroy the hopes of my people, then I'm done with you.
All you need to know is that I'm giving you an order to fall in line.
So that's it. All this time, and that's all I get from you. How can you not see what this means to the Krogan? This base can't be destroyed. I won't allow it.
Saren doesn't care about these Krogan. They're tools, puppets. He'll destroy them as soon as they're no longer useful to him. Is that what you want for your people?
No. We were tools for the Council once. Thank us for wiping out the Rachni. They neutered us all. I doubt Saren will be as generous. All right, Shepard. You made your point. I don't like this, but I trust you enough to follow your lead. Just one thing. When we find Saren, I want his head.
All right. I think we've made some progress here. And I think we're going to call it a day, but to kind of finish what I was talking about with the classes, the last two classes, which really aren't my favorite, soldiers, which are basically normal attack spam meat tanks, they have really good survivability in this, which is actually kind of reduced in the later games, though admittedly how broken it can be at times, that's not necessarily a bad thing. And their main thing is just shooting and having a lot of ways to boost their damage output. But as I said, in this one it's more about boosting their defensive output. They really get the more offensive output, but then again the combat mechanics in the later games get a lot more offensively oriented anyway. But yeah, I already mentioned that the gunplay isn't really my favorite aspect of particularly this one of the this game, so I'm not a big fan of the soldiers. And then last but not least, the Sentinel, which I really don't know what they were going for the Sentinel. It feels like that was supposed to be the defensive class, except that because the mechanics and the way things work, the soldier ended up being that in this game. The later games, they add like through the unique skills a really good defensive option for the Sentinels, but it kind of leaves you like, I don't know, it just doesn't seem as good to me. I feel like there's probably a lot more to be said there, but I need to think what I want to say about it. So I guess we'll actually leave that discussion for the moment. I guess tune in next time where, well, we're going to chat with Kirahi there and see where we're going on this mission. I think we'll bring Rex along. It seems like a good plan. Anyway, until then though, as always, later folks.